Hi guys, good evening. This is a presentation for the players briefing. Before we start the briefing itself, definitely we will need to thank our sponsor. So to our main and also Titan sponsor itself, Petaling BC. Petaling BC will be offering their locations at Makuta Cheras, Sentosa and also Puchong Sport Arena itself for our events. I would like to thank you very much for Petaling BC itself for their support. And our next sponsor, JJ Sport House, which is also the sponsor for Social Series, have yet to sponsor another of our events again. I would like to thank you to Mr. Ong from owner himself of JJ Sport House for supporting us once again. Thank you very much. And JJ Sport House itself, which have two branches. One is located at the Taman Bukit Maruri, this is all in Kepong. And another one is in the badminton hall itself, called the 222 Sports Center in the KIPs, in Taman Perindustrian Tago. Okay, I would thank you very much to JJ Sport House. Next, our next sponsor, Spotify. Also another sponsor of our social series, our official sports apps partners. You can download the software itself from the App Store and Google Play Store. What the software actually is to find the places to play badminton and also some other sport like basketball, tennis, golf. So you can freely download itself from the App Store and also Google Play Store. Thank you to our sports apps partner Spotify for supporting our event again. Thank you very much. And next, our auspicious sponsor, which is a VCS AV Connections Srinivasan Berhad. I would like to thanks to Mr. Yip, which also have a long support of ZeuSport in our events. Not just a sponsor himself, Mr. Yip also take part in all our events like social series and also Modus Liga, providing us videos, sounds, light and staging whenever we need it. So I would like to thank you very much to Mr. Yip once again for supporting us throughout the years. And last but not least, 222 Sports Center itself, which will be hosting our opening games coming this Saturday at branches which is located at Kepong, nearby the KIP Kepong Industrial Park. And also 222 Sports Center itself will also have two other branches. One is located at Selayang Mall and the other one in Sedapa is called the Lavana Sports Center. I want to thank you very much to 222 Sports Center itself for the first time ever supporting our events. So before we start to discussions on the matters, I think that it's better for me to explain to you the keywords that will be used in the sound of the briefing in a while. So like the match day itself, when we say match day, is considered a match day is the date allocated for the league. As for this season of Modus Liga, 8 match days have been allocated. So 7 days itself is for the round robin, and also 1 more day itself is for the semi-final and final of Modus Liga. So we call this as match day. Try to laser point. This we will consider as match day. Ties itself, right? Each tie is a team versus another team. As for this season, there will be 2 ties in each match day. So it's just an example like we have a few teams like Saturn and also maybe Neptune and also Venus. So Venus versus Neptune is considered 1 tie. And within a match day itself, we will have 2 ties. So Venus will play against another team, maybe let's say example Saturn itself, in another tie. So there's 2 tie in a day. Matches. So matches each is a match within a tie. Okay, as for this season itself, there will be 3 matches played in a tie. So 3 matches will be played in a single tie. And also in the single day itself, we have two ties. So total of six matches. Right? Games. Games, each match are consists of best of three games of 21 points each with deuce. So this is what we call games. Alright, a lot of people were using like set and stuff. Actually, set doesn't belong to badminton, it belongs to tennis. So in the game of badminton itself, right, we don't use a set. So I hope that this is an explanation telling you, know the terms that we need to use. Even in your team communications with your players, with a captain himself, his best himself, right, you know all these things, alright? Formats of competition in brief, very fast, I'm gonna go through this. So we have a total of 8 teams. It's a double round robin. Now double round robin, which means you will meet each team right twice in this season itself. So each tie itself consists of 3 matches. So each match are best of 3 games, 21 points with deuce. Each players are mandatory to play in 4 ties. 4 ties. Team that walk over, 0 count, however retirement count. You see, one each player himself, right, you will need to play in at least 4 ties, alright? But if let's say you walk over, right, which means the team that walk over, you will have 0 count. But the team that actually came the opponent himself actually came to the court himself in order to play, but the other team walk over, then the team present at the court itself will be allocated as 1 tie. Alright? So however retirements, let's say it's like, of course we don't want this to happen. Like definitely the injury, so like these sort of things that happen, unfortunate things happen. But say in the middle of the game, then the player will need to retire himself, right? Then all the appearance of 1 tie itself will still be count. Alright? So, top 4 teams are qualified to the semi-finals and final days. The top 4 in our tables itself. So, the top 4 itself will qualify to the semi-finals on the final days. Right? Tiebreakers, these tiebreakers, right? In the table, in our league table itself, we will go for match win. Alright? Then match loss. Game wins, and also game loss. If the tie of the winning and losing right is even within two teams, so we will use these factors like match win, match loss, game win, and game loss. Alright, so very 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 easy. Alright, match day time has been changed to 7 p.m. to 11 p.m. as requested by most of the players itself. So we have changed our prime time, which is previously from 8 to 12 a.m. to 7 to 11 a.m. p.m. Sorry, p.m. Okay, other important issues. Okay, let's go then. The first thing will be umpires and linesmen will be done by the team players. So we actually don't want to employ any outside umpires and also linesmen because it's going to be very costly. And you just don't want to increase the fees of the per match. So somehow we will require person that actually sit on the chairs itself as a linesman. We will ask for your and also the umpires. You will need your integrity. I mean, you have to be fair. You need your fairness. You need to be committed. Which means if let's say you are the linesman of the particular matches, and we hope that you concentrate yourself, you do what you need to do. So you just don't halfway, just talking to your friend and such, and didn't really put yourself into the game and really be the linesman of the game. So because this is the lines call is quite important. So you can see the best. So we need you to be 100% concentrated, meaning 100% committed yourself. When let's say you want to be a linesman, then you have to be really committed. So you need to concentrate yourself, alright? And also that the umpire and linesman, right, it will be done by the team player himself. And I heard before that players like, you know, they refuse to become the umpires, they refuse to become the linesman. I know it's a big it's sometimes it's pressure you have to be a linesman. Okay, because you whenever you call yourself right, definitely where some people will say otherwise. They say it's in, you say it's in, but they say it's out. So of course things will happen, alright? But somehow yourself, right, it's a team effort, so you will need to like stand out. I mean, try to help your team, because everybody is there itself to play, so everybody will have one match, and if you don't help, right, then it's like kind of like, you know, already captain himself and vice captain have bundles to do. Definitely it will be the umpires, they have so much things to do. But then they don't get your help themselves, right? Then it's like, it's quite tough. So when you are a team, then everybody plays a part. Even you are not playing on the day itself, or you are playing and in the second tie, you can come early yourself to help out the team. So by just becoming a linesman, or maybe just by becoming an umpires, and also many things that you can do for the teams. If you really want to do something for the teams, you can even go that early yourself, right? You can actually evaluate other teams, other pairings that they put through, because these are the team that your team will meet in the future or in the next match day. You also can be like helping your team itself in a lot of ways, giving support and stuff, you know. Of course, if you, let's say you finish your game in first tie, you can also stay back, you know, helping to do all these linesmen and stuff. Because right, I think last season I saw a team itself, where the last pair is playing for the day, and only the captains and also the two players that which is in the court are playing, and all other people itself right all disappeared. Then the captain is have to become the umpires of the match, and there's no player itself right from the team itself to become the linesman, so which is I think is quite bad lah. I mean, of course, you know, it's a teamwork in the sport itself, right, is not much different itself in the corporate world. So if you are good, you are very good team players in the sports, you will be a very good team players itself in the corporate world. So I hope that all the players, you know, don't just act like a players, because the team need your support. So maybe you can stay back, or maybe you can come early yourself to help out certain things. Okay, so line call. Second thing is a line call. Oh, sorry, line calls. Line calls will be made by linesmen. Teammates are not allowed to assist at players. Last season we have hear teammates like shouting for the players of their teammate himself not to take the shuttle because he's out and stuff. I hope that I know this is not a fault or the things that you cannot do. Or let's say you are in the big stadium itself, then all the spectators will be shouting yes loud and clear and everything, saying in and out of things. But that is in the stadium where the spectators will be sitting far away itself from the players. Even the coaches, as I know, they are not allowed to help the players for this line call. They are not allowed. They just can keep sit there, and once the play is like interval, let's say they win 1 point, then the coach can start talking, like maybe giving advice himself to the players. But during the game, before the shuttles actually the rally is ended, right, they cannot help. They cannot actually help. So I hope that all the players and also players and teammates themselves can try to act appropriately lah. I mean, towards this matter, because I think this one is happened last season. So I don't hope that this will be happen again. A lot of things that we didn't know that it will happen last season. So this season itself, right, we will try to make this all clear itself before that. We don't want things to turn bad. We created this Morris Liga itself. Actually, it's for, you know, fun. Everybody to enjoy, feel the competitiveness, and socialize and stuff. But we don't want to see arguments, conflict and stuff also. All right, next will be the coaches. Alright, last season itself, you can see five or six people itself rushing to the court during the interval, giving advices to the two players of their team. Seriously, if all the five players is talking, right, who the two players, these two players, right, is going to listen to? So it's like a mess. But we actually, last season itself, we advise all the team itself, right, to only have two representatives. Alright, go into the court during the interval itself and give valuable advice itself to the players. But I never say that the other three, let's say now you got five, the other three can actually discuss, you know, you can discuss outside the court. Okay, during the play itself, you can actually give your opinions, suggestions or whatsoever to the two coaches that they appointed to actually talk to the players, give the advice itself. So I'll hopefully this season itself we are gonna see two people only. We don't see like a whole bunch of people itself going to the side of the court and tell the players what to do. That basically will actually make them more confused. The next will be the players please act appropriately. Provoking, brawling are not encouraged. Please maintain your good sportsmanship attitudes. Definitely Bundesliga is a badminton league and is owned by all the hub members and also Zeus Sport as well, and also is proudly sponsored by a lot of our sponsor. So it's a place to play badminton, to bring out the good things, you know, from all the players. So it's not a place that to express your own grudge. Like you don't like a certain players or certain members within the hub itself, which is playing in the league. So you try to insult him, you know, during the game by shouting so loud and such thing. No, this is provoking. Also in the provoking. So we really don't encourage all these type of things to happen. So if you want to support, then support properly. No. Not specifically try to insult a certain individuals or maybe a certain individual team, right? Your own grudge or your own problems with between this individual and self, right, is to be solved outside of Bundesliga, outside of badminton court. You can go somewhere else. This is not a place for you to show your anger, right? This is a place for us to enjoy and have fun and other stuff, other good stuff, no bad stuff. So I also like to ask the players themselves to maintain sportsmanship. No line calls, let's say it's in, then it's in, you know, because now we already told the linesman himself they have to be concentrate, you know, during their duties himself as a linesman. So and also no brawling and stuff, try to insult the openers, or even you are inside the court or outside the court itself, which is not nice. I mean joke, I'm okay with jokes, no problems. Yeah, everybody try to have fun and a little laugh itself will be okay. Right? So please players itself, please act appropriately. Alright, next will be the shuttlecock usage, extremely care. We have been overused the shuttle itself for the last season. Every match day itself, right, overused by almost 2 tube. Now, I'm saying again, after I've said in the social series, is that I never say I disallowed you all to use your shuttle. Change your shuttle. You can change when the condition of the shuttle is very bad. Alright, but not until like super bad, like if just a feather, everything is like peel off only, you want to change. No, not until that extent. Okay, when the shuttle is not flying at the correct trajectory, or it's like shaking, it's turning, no, you can change. Go ahead and change, because you need to enjoy the game. So shuttle is like that, no, maybe disrupt your timing itself when you're playing, or when you try to execute a stroke. So it's okay, you can change it, but I really don't encourage people itself to change the shuttle itself, right, just so the shuttle can go faster when it smash. I don't really think that badminton game is win by smashes only and just by smashes. So changing the shuttle 7 times or maybe more than that during a best of 3 21 points itself, right, doesn't really will secure the win for your teams. So it's just a wastage only. It's just a wastage, right? So please be extremely careful about this the court usage. Alright, registration, deposit, match, and team t-shirt fees. Alright, these fees itself, I have to tell the people that actually first time joining us in the Modestliga, your money, everything will be well calculated, and we will never take a single cent of you unless it's written down there that you need to pay up. Alright, registration is 30 ringgit, deposit itself is 50 ringgit. Each match you play, right, then you deduct from your deposit. Because we found that it's very difficult itself to ask the player to pay every time they come. Sometimes you forget. Sometimes captain himself like, oh man, I've got so many things to do. God, after that suddenly he's just like, oh, man, the player went back already without telling any new. You also don't know. So this is the issues itself that we face, Bundesliga for the past, since it begins. So we try to minimize all this headache itself that the captains or also the vice captain have. We try to take everything right up front, so then we deduct accordingly. The team t-shirt itself is not mandatory. You want to buy, you can buy, and also design, I think it's already sent to your handphone. The sizes itself, right, you also can actually test it out this Saturday, and we will give you the ready t-shirt itself the next match day, which is the next Saturday. Okay, so don't worry if Seal Sport me itself already maybe lie your money or con your money itself, right? I think we won't be survived until now. Zeus Sport have now have history of almost 8 years already. Yes, we are that long. Bundesliga have been run for almost 6 years, if I'm not mistaken, maybe 5 or 6 years. I haven't really exactly check out and also written down our history in Zeus Sport. You have to definitely, if let's say we are that kind of person itself, right, definitely we definitely will be like, there's a Facebook, you know, we were a lot of people were talking about us, talk bad about us and stuff, right? So team t-shirt already mentioned just now, so we will get it on the next Saturday. Testing on the sizes itself, you can do it on this Saturday, as I will bring a few sizes itself for you to test. So test before you play the match, okay? Alright, next, attendance, commitments, and respect to the team. This is a long issues that we've been facing since the first day of Modestliga. So I mean, sometimes players need to know that they will need to confirm their attendance as soon as possible. You know why? The captains, right, and also the vice captain is having a very, very tough time. Okay, let's say now you reconfirm your attendance, you are coming on that day, on Saturday itself. All the vice captain and also captain, maybe some of their key players itself, they start to discuss 2 or 3 hours. Okay, this is the finals lineup that you're gonna put this coming Saturday. And all of a sudden, on Friday, maybe night or maybe in the morning itself, somebody can't make it. Actually, the initial plan was he to play, but he can't make it now. Do you know that what is the problem is gonna face by this team captain, vice captain, and some others, maybe their advisor as well? They might need to change the whole thing, you know? Crack their head again, calculate the rating points again to make sure that everybody entitled to that particular category and stuff that you will never know. Because obviously, definitely, if let's say it's an emergency, definitely we say we can go. No, there's no problem. We can do calculation again because it's an emergency. But when you say you can make it and try to, we hope that you can try your best to make it. Because all the captains and vice captain is going to scratch their head again and do a whole new lineup. It might be you need, sometimes we will hit that, you need to retransfer everything, re-strategize everything. So there's a dilemma of a captains and also a vice captain and such. No, you just like you'll be stuck in the world and you're just like, oh my god, now my this player cannot come and now I cannot do this strategy anymore because I need to change. Because maybe this player itself have certain abilities that other players in the team don't have. Okay, now I have to change. Then during they are working as well. Okay, they are working people. Mostly of us playing in the Molus League are working people. There will be like headache, you know, in the office also they headache about what is the strategy they need to put in the lineup. So we hope that and also we also ask for respect, commitments. Definitely, you know, if you once you say you can make it, you know, you try your best yourself to make it, and also need to respect the team. Obviously, because why? Everybody's opinions is opinions. You don't see that I really don't like particular people is that looking at somebody else. Let's say this player is not that good. All right, maybe he's a C or D levels players, and he's trying to give us opinions. What is he himself to give us an opinion and such? No, I don't really like this type of particular person. No, you should respect that person himself. Yeah, maybe he's not a good player or whatsoever, but that doesn't really justify you yourself to disrespect such people, or I will call this a discrimination. Alright? No, this league itself, right, what we are doing itself, actually to let every players of any levels to play in our tournaments. Even the social series, we have category A, B, and C. And now Molus Liga also, even the three matches itself are separated to three type of levels. No, we want to encourage anybody to play. Alright? We don't really care about their standard, you know, how either they are good or not, or so and such. If they want to play, you know, they are not troublemakers, we welcome them to play. Alright? So this no discriminations of levels and stuff. No, you don't think you are very good, you are the state players itself, or maybe you are national players itself, then you can start to insult other people's. Oh no, that is not what I created for this purpose. I don't like to see this type of thing, definitely. Alright? So I hope that you respect your captain, your vice captain. If you have anything to say yourself, say it professionally, say it properly, or in a well manner. Talk to them nicely and try to see what is their feedback to you. Then let's say it's a majority team wanted, you know, just accept it. No, you might think it's right, but the other maybe 12 players themselves think it's wrong. Right, then they want to do the right thing, so no, you just follow whatever the teams, let's say there's a vote itself, you have to follow, right? So the live result itself also can be viewed in our Modus Liga website. So you saw this little icon itself in the main page itself. Just click on it, then you will see actually the live score. If let's say you are interested to know the other matches in progress right now, who is winning, who is losing, what team is leading the tie or whatsoever, you can actually, no need to ask anybody, you can actually go to this icon itself, click on it, then the live result itself will be displayed there, which means once the game is finished, then we will actually update to our system, then from there itself you can see on the website. And also we will see you can see on our projector screen, which is 10 times 10 feet. Also, you can see from there the result of the matches, right? All team info also you can actually find in our zeosport.com/motorsiga. I think a lot of people already went there and have a look. So you can see whoever himself in which team, and also who have the captain himself in which team. Alright, so okay, I think that's all. And the last and least, like this is I think quite a major issue, which is the rating panels. At the beginning, that I want to actually introduce all the rating panel for this year, which is this year 2018. The rating panel itself they have already done for social series, first series, then they also do the rating itself for Modus Liga 2018. So, but I want to know why so many people asking me who is the rating panels. Now, give me a good reason why you need to know. Because some of the reason that I receive itself is like, I want to know the panel, who are they? Are they qualified itself, or are they good enough itself to actually rate me? So this is the thing, it's just a thing that the reason they want to know. But I want no more reason. You give me more better reason itself, right? Then actually I will tell you who is the rating panels. As of now, I don't think that is a good reason. Because why? I'm just try to protect the rating panels if I can. And next year 2019 itself, right, the rating panel may change. That we're not gonna expose or we're not gonna tell you who is the rating, the latest new rating panels. Because why? That I mean most of them are just by joke. You know, maybe like ask the panel itself to give them a lower rating and stuff. But these rating panels is really one of the very key components in the whole Zeus Sport, in the whole setup of a hub. And the rating itself also is very important itself for Monastiga, and also very very important itself for Social Series. So you just imagine that when you go to a tournament like Social Series and also Monastiga, you start to see like, you know, very weird rating issues that have been issues, players which is like maybe supposed to be A has been rated to C and stuff. So will you have interest in self to joining the Bundesliga again or even a Social Series again? No? So this is very important. The rating panels is very very important for the survival of Bundesliga and also the Social Series. No, we will never try to expose their name, right, in order for them to protect them in a way that they don't really like yet really like I don't say harassment or abuse or whatsoever, but calls from the players itself asking, no, I want this trade, please give me this trade, and we don't want that to like no receive, no, we got 100 over members itself, we don't want to this panel itself to receive call from 100 of people asking for all the rates that they want. Okay, so that's why me myself as a founder of Zeus Sport itself, right, have decided to keep their name secrets for now. And 2019, once we appointed the new panels, maybe new, maybe existing, we'll never know. We're not gonna tell. We are not gonna tell anybody who is actually the panels. Give me a good reason first. If I think that is a very good reason itself, right, then I will tell who is the panels. But as of now, I don't think so. I want to actually release out who is the panels itself for this. So rating panels itself, this year 2018, we have two ratings, which is Social Series 2018. There's one rating. Your rating will never change a call throughout the series, right, until the finals is over. Then we have another new rating itself for Bundesliga. This is what we rate after we observe your performance itself in Social Series, first series, and so second series. So this is your final Bundesliga rating. So there's two rating. Don't get confused, right? Why my slide is not moving? Alright. So I think that's about it for the players briefing. Let's say you have any question which you don't understand, maybe you can try to advise your captains. Let's say they cannot answer you, then definitely they will come to me itself for advice. Alright, so I will see you this coming Saturday, 6th of October, our first match day itself, which will be happen in the venue 222 Sports Center in KIP, Kepong Industrial Park. I'll see you soon. And that's all from me, Teddy Tan, signing off.